So I have Mr. Charlie here. We've done him before. I love him. I've been doing him for a hot minute. I was originally doing him out of my mother-in-law's house. But then she started coming here. So we are going to give him a nice trim up, get him ready for the new year, and let's get this going. It's not loud at all. I really downplayed this for y'all. Like, I thought it wasn't really good on big dogs, but if you hold it a certain way, it actually is. It's really good. And it comes with a nail clipper too, and a top for this, so in case you don't want to have a top off. But I recommend having a top off. Anyway, here's my nail clippers. I don't know what happened to my big nail clippers. I'm missing two nail clippers here. Did I get a little too close on that one? I'm sorry, buddy.
Quick dog,
but I didn't quick you.
No, I didn't.
I saw your cute friend last week. Yeah, your partner in crime is here.
I know. Okay, we'll find that one.
Now this is a diamond head. The diamond head are supposed to last a lot longer. So that's why I think really think this is a deal, because usually if you buy just a diamond head, the diamond head could be anywhere from $30 to $40 just for one little tiny piece. And this I think is like $20, $22, something like that. This is chargeable. You can use the regular charging thing that you would use for your phone or your tablet. I'm gonna blow them out a little bit more. Because he's got some undercoat because he's sticking out. I couldn't get it all out the coat. This may take a little bit longer to dry.
Folks. fuzzy, buddy. He's a little fuzzy. He's a fuzzy fuzzy. He's a fuzzy fuzzy.
I need you to do fuzzy fuzzy.
Such a good boy.
You're such a good boy. You're such a good boy. I know. I love you. I love you.
Well, I hope everybody's Christmas was very nice. Mine was very quiet. The older kids got their gifts early. And then the toddlers got theirs on Christmas Day. Addison walked by the gifts multiple times, which was quite hilarious because there's two bikes in the front that have little baby sharks on them. So I don't know how she could have passed them. But she did. Having a get together for New Year's. If she does, we gotta make sure we get all this undercoat out. We knew she wasn't gonna play. We still gotta get the undercoat out anyway. And this way, Charlie will be able to regulate his temperature. And he doesn't have his pores clogged up, his hair. Think of the coat as a filter. That's what I normally like to tell people. Think of it as a filter. If your dog has a lot of undercoat and it's shedding, the pores are blocked, so they can't regulate the air properly through their skin. It doesn't circulate properly because if you were a filter, you'd have all that debris and dust and stuff on the filter. So in order for it to get better circulation and better air going through your house, you have to what? You have to change your filter. Well, with the dogs, to do that, you have to give them a bath or brush them out. Giving them a bath and brushing them out would be the best because it opens up the pores and it really helps get all that loose undercoat. And then the rest of the undercoat after you've brushed and blow dried will eventually come out within 24 hours. I usually say 24 to 48 hours. And that's where all the rest of the undercoat will come out. It'll fall out naturally. But you getting the bath, blow it out, and brushing helps it a lot. And I cannot stress how much combing impacts your dog. Now this kind of dog, you can use a comb like I'm using, or you can use a rake. But I just like to use my comb on these guys. It really gets down in there. Plus, I need to order a new rake anyway. I'm ordering one Friday. There's a new one somebody was telling me about. And it's been very popular on the Facebook grooming groomer pages. It's an Andis. It's by Andis. It's an Andis shedding tool. It's only like $20. So I'm going to get that Friday, order it Friday, and I'll let you guys know what I think about it. You know, if it's worth the big cahoots that we're talking. Because sometimes people hype stuff up and then you get it and you're like, why are they hyping it up? This is horrible. And you're going to use my 9 comb, and then we're going to use a comb and a half, 1.5 comb. And I'm doing this on his butt.
See the butt a little better. Let's get in there really tight.
Sorry. because it's a little bit easier for me to do it from this side than it is to have it on the other side. Come on, go down. There we go. See how that already, you can't see one like that, let's see the but doing this kind of sculpts the budding a little bit. And it takes off scissor time. So do the sanitary really quick. Hold on, buddy. I know. By your booty hole. Always do this with a 10. We found the booty hole. Here it is. I'm just going to shave this part of it real quick. So we can, so I'll turn you this way. Lift you up. I usually like to start right here where the belly button or the umbilical cord was. That's where I shave to. That's my shaving point. The little groomer is different, so. Get the hairs off your little weenie. Now we got the private in, and now we're going to go back to this butt here. Okay? See that nice butt that it's already given him? Just by trimming that little bit off of his butt. It's a nice butt. It's a nice butt, isn't it? I know. And we haven't even finished it yet. We still got to scissor it up just a little bit. But his butt's going to be amazing. It's going to be the best I've ever seen. Like Donald Trump says. I've heard many things about it. It's amazing. It's the best butt you'll ever see. So basically what I do is, I'm gonna put y'all up here real quick. Actually, I'm gonna put you over here. So this way the music doesn't go off too loud so I don't have to have a copyright and change the music. So what I normally do from this point after I've done this, I like to fluff up the back of the tail just above it, because now that your butt is down, you have to make sure that this part is nice, because it almost, if you look where it is, it almost looks like it's got like a bubble butt up here. And we don't want him to have a bubble butt because we made his butt right here a little bit short. So I'm trying to find my chunkers, and I don't know where I put them. My chunkers, I'll fluff this up, and I'm just gonna go over it and just blend it kind of in, blend it down. I'm just taking like about a half an inch, if that off. Because you want everything to blend perfectly. You want it to act like, you know, as if this is how the dog's coat naturally lays. And see how much that, just trimming off that little bit, you already see a difference. Already see a difference. I'm gonna do the same thing down here. I'm not taking a lot off. I'm just taking the sticky outies and I'm just conforming it and blending it into the back of his leg. I don't want to take this tube down because we already took quite a bit off. So just blending. Blend it all the way down from his knee. Making sure we get these little white, little tiny whiskies. So look at that. Now we have a nice butt. We have a nice leg and it goes all the way up and it looks natural. And that's what we want. And we'll do the same thing to this leg. And as you can see, this part sticks out over here. I mean, you can see the difference between each leg from right here from where I have it. It's all about blending. If you're not good with blending, you can start off with a pair of thin shears. It might take you a little bit longer, but it'll get you to where you have the confidence enough to use a pair of chunkers like these, because these scissors can be very intimidating. They were when I first started using them and I didn't know how to use them properly, and I was just, oof. I put some chunks in some dolls in a coat and it did not look pretty at all. But this was also many, many years ago. You can use a guard comb here and go down the body. I'm just going to scissor. I usually just hand scissor to him. The only part that I usually trim up for the guard comb is usually back here if it's really, really low. Sometimes I don't, but take your time.
I know. You see right there, okay, Bubba?
Now make sure when you come to the front or the side of your dog, you're trimming up the hair that's inside of here. You always want to make sure you get the hair inside of here, and there's hair like right underneath the armpit right here that you want to make sure you get, because when you walk behind the dog, you can see that hair sticking out. The owner might not realize that, but you as a groomer will notice it. Scissor it that way, or if you want, you can also fluff this part up right here if you want it to be a little bit neater, and then just scissor this part at like kind of like a at an angle in a sense, like kind of like that. I'm gonna show you on the camera, but I'm kind of special, so I'm just doing an editing box. See how that kind of shapes it in a little bit better?
Opposed to this side,
where I just scissored underneath.
So now I'm just going to fluff up the other side and do the same thing that I just did the other side.
I cannot stand this part on dogs, and I seem to be like a lot of dogs seem to have that little tiny hair that just sticks up right there and above this front arm. I don't know what it is, but it drives me bonkers. And make sure you get this hair like right here when I'm scissoring. I never scissored there. I never even knew about that. But when my friend Mike, he retrained me back when I was working in Ohio, he showed me all that good stuff. Sorry, buddy, I know you're about to lay down and get all comfy. I know. I took all of it. We're almost done, okay? I promise. We're almost done. You can get back his legs. Now you can brush this down like this. You're going to want to scissor like a half of the moon. You don't really want to go straight because it's not going to really come out straight. This part up, push it forwards, bring it up. Almost like a little mohawk, you know? And then and scissor it upwards, again, like a moon shape. You can do this with thinners, you can do this with chunkers. If you're brave enough, you can use it with a hard course here. Straight or curved, I'd probably recommend it curved. I like to do it with chunkers or thinners because it makes it look smoother and runs it in nicer. That plus if I make a boo-boo. I can fix my boo-boo.
It's a lot harder to fix a boo-boo when you have a harder carter shear.
Stick out on the side here, behind his ears and stuff. We're gonna trim that up. And you can't see this side, but you'll see what I'm doing here in a second.
keep your body in a certain position. Do with his pads and his feet. So I'm doing this with a 40. This is another really good thing to get whether you're a groomer or you're at home. This is really good for the in-between grooms. Shaving the feet. In between the eyes. I wouldn't really recommend shaving a private area with this. I mean, I haven't had any issues, but it is really short. So some dogs, it can cause some irritation and itching too. The marshmallow that I got for my Secret Santa, Miss Erin. She's amazing. I also got her, I picked out her gift that was at our Christmas party, Dirty Santa. It was an oil diffuser, and I told anybody if they touched it, I was going to beat them up. And nobody touched it. So this is marshmallow. Let it fall naturally. You smell amazing.
You smell like a Krispy Kreme treat.
Look at how handsome he is. He is just so handsome, y'all. Look at him. Just look at him. Just look at him in all his glory.
He's just a happy little boy. He's just a happy little boy. Yes, he is.
Well, that's the cut, y'all. I appreciate y'all for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.